Toni, this could really affect people's selection at local stores.
Absolutely, Craig. You know, inside this brewery, Lakefront has four new beers are trying to get approval to release. Now, one is currently brewing inside. The others are ready to be brewed and given a label like this one, but can't because of the government shutdown.
When you enter Milwaukee's Lakefront Brewery, one of the first people you may run into is John Zutz. He's been with the brewery since it opened 25 years ago.
I have done just about everything at the brewery. Right now I'm a tour guide.
He's also getting to create his own dark cherry beer.
I've been telling the boss all along that we should be making this dark cherry, and now I get my chance to do it.
Through the company's program, My Turn, each employee gets a chance to design a beer and have it bottled.
We should be in the tank right now, fermenting.
But because each label and recipe must first be approved by the Alcohol and Tobacco Tax and Trade Bureau, the My Turn John beer can't be made.
Inside this tank and this tank over here is Lakefront's holiday spice beer. Because it requires some aging, they've already started the brewing process. But due to the government shutdown, labels for the beer haven't been approved, keeping it from being bottled.
So that's taking up tank space that we could be using to do our year-round beers.
Dan Alexandrovich is Lakefront's tax and compliance manager. He says in addition to those two brews, Lakefront is trying to release the last installment of its anniversary beer and a 12-ounce bottle of their India Black Ale.
You can't really progress. We've got a lot of growth we could do.
And with the holiday season approaching, they could be losing out on making money.
I was hoping to give it for Christmas presents.
Well, he may not be able to. Lakefront managers tell me the shutdown is not currently costing them any money, but they could be losing out on about $1,000 a week by not releasing the four brews on time in November. Live in Milwaukee, Toni Valliere, WISN 12 News.